Do you feel that you're pulled to the darker part of the show sometimes too much, or the lighter side? Do you have a little bit of a fight with yourself to kind of keep the whole show encompass joy too?
It's very funny. Season two, the first half of it, it is relentless because she's hard, and I decided, and it's challenging. You get nervous. Is the audience going to stick with you? But I decided the first half of season two was I was meditating on the idea of this idea where people say, oh, let it go, move on. You know, how do you move on? What's the drama look like to move on? How do you let the one you thought you were going to love go? And so oftentimes you take two steps backwards before you can take one step forward. So the first six episodes follow that notion. And she's angry, and part of letting go, you get angry. And when you don't have the person you're really angry at to be angry toward, you become angry toward other people. and that's how we sort of operate sometimes in the world. And so I just let her do that. And then she's just started doing things, and you start to, like, she froze her eggs on air, because we've seen that before. We've seen news anchors use their personal stories, and then we've seen that. We've seen that, so that's familiar. But really, so is she freezing her eggs and hurry up trying to get a baby because the guy who broke her heart is having a baby with another woman? So you start to, all of those sort of things. Right. To the outside world, she's just another reporter doing one of those infotainment things, you know. But my point being, once she sort of exhausted herself with that, I decided the midway we have to turn her. She's got to, she's a grown woman. She's not 20. That's another thing. We have a grown people, like in life, they're less patient people, right, the older they are. Like, get over it, you know. But it's hard to get over it. But anyway, we decided halfway we have to make the switch. We have to show her growing, but there's drama even in that. Right. And that's when some of the other outside forces, and that's the thing, sometimes Mary Jane, like in this particular episode, she actually had no drama that day. And one of the balances is, like, when she's sort of being a bad girl in one episode, then the next episode, I let her be the good girl and be the rescuer to others. Because in that same episode, right before she goes and interviews, meets with the sex trafficking, which is a personal issue of mine. I'm appalled by that, so I use my platform to talk about it. But right before that scene, you find out one of her coworkers, again, I'm borrowing from Anderson Cooper and Don Lemon. They're gay men who are not out publicly. They're out within their private life, but not out. And so as a grown man, his parents are sort of like, he's panicked. And you find out Mary Jane is his beard when his parents come to town. So it's actually, you enter into the story very funny. And she's making up these stories and lying for him. And then I'm so proud of the scene. It's this outing scene with his parents, but it takes a twist. It's not just the typical outing scene. But anyway, it's sort of, or coming out, I would say. It's kind of outing the most part. But anyway, the point is, she just is doing that. And how she gets out of that moment is her phone goes off and she's like, remember that interview I told you I had to get to? It's like the worst moment of her friend's life. Right. And she has to go, and she goes to the next thing, she's trying to save a girl. Anyway, it's really, it's a lot of fun, and it can be overwhelming sometimes because I have so much I want to say and so much I set in motion. You also have to keep track of the things that you put out. And so it becomes like the cast is growing. The budget is growing.